praise when I'm sure, praise when I'm doubting. I'll praise when outnumbered, praise when surrounded. Cause praise is the water my enemies drown in. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. I'll praise when I feel it, I'll praise when I don't. I'll praise cause I know you're still in control. Cause my praise is a weapon, it's more than a sound. My praise is a shout that brings Jericho down. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. I won't be quiet if my God is alive. How could I keep it aside? Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign, praise cause you rose and defeated the grave. I'll praise cause you're faithful, praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody greater than you. I'll praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign, praise cause you rose and defeated the grave. I'll praise cause you're faithful, praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody.
Ready for the greeting? Alleluia. Christ is risen. Good morning. Easter's greetings to you all. Wow, wasn't that great to have all these young people? Yeah, you know, Teresa, Steve, Penny, Pat, you're
Did
young.
You just call us young?
Yeah, all these young people. rallying us with that wonderful opening for a day, yes, we should jump and shout and dance and clap for joy because Christ is risen. Peace to you from our Lord Jesus Christ. We are here today at Maple Grove Lutheran Church to acknowledge, to embrace, and celebrate his rising. Resurrection that reminds us that every day is a miracle because we're here, we're smiling, we're crying, all of it because of him and his sacrifice. I feel blessed seeing all your faces this morning. To see Christ so alive in this community of faith fills me with a joy that I really can't express fully now. It would take up most of this Sunday. And we have great news to share. But I do thank God for each and every one of you this day. And it's my prayer that both you and our visitors, family, and friends joining today will feel God's welcome, hear the good news of the resurrection and new life, and know God loves you. It's through our life together in Christ we have so many things to do, so many good things going on. That's our newsletter, Take It Home. Come join us again for worship. Join Bible studies. Serve together. Grow in faith and fellowship here. Next Sunday, we give thanks for 10 youth who will be receiving their first communion. There's a women's retreat coming up April 20th. The theme is God Sees Me. How wonderful. You can sign up even in the church office today. There's a blessing of bikes, trikes, bicycles, motorcycles, scooters, and all wheeled things on April 14th after worship. And then we'll gather again outside on April 21st to bless our community garden. Yes, spring is coming. I want to give a shout out of Easter blessings to family and friends joining us live stream as well. He is risen indeed. Thanks to our worship team, our AV sound, everybody who's helping to welcome and host our worship today. And now please rise for our opening song.
Thank you. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption. And by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. All the children should please come forward for the Easter message.
Good Easter morning. There we are. Good Easter morning, children. Hi, everyone. You look so nice today. Come have a seat. There's Teddy and Charlotte. Yes, yes. Good to see you all. Good morning. We are so glad you are with us today. We have such good news to share on Easter. Well, I figure you might recognize this, and we'll get to this in just a minute, okay? Yes, yes, yes. But I have a question. Do you know why Easter is such a happy day? Yes. Jesus finally rose on the third day. What were you going to say? Jesus rose from the dead. That's right. That's why Easter is such a happy day. And look at all the flowers blooming and the church all decked out in white and gold. Yes?
When the soldiers got Jesus right on the cross and died.
He did. Let's talk about that. The soldiers got Jesus on the cross and he died, didn't he? So, on Easter Sunday, though, did you hear us? We say something that's victorious, don't we, to each other? Jesus is risen. That's what we say to each other. Yep. Remember the leaders who didn't want Jesus to be king. That's what you were talking about. And so they put Jesus to death on the cross. And Jesus' friends were so sad. They took his body, they wrapped it in a white linen cloth, and they laid him in a tomb. A tomb is like a cave. And then there was a big stone rolled over the tomb where Jesus' body lay. But when Jesus' friends came to his tomb on Easter Sunday, that stone was rolled away. Jesus was alive. God raised Jesus to life again. So we say Jesus is risen on Easter Sunday, and that he gives us, because of that, we get new life by knowing him. And then at the end of our life, when we die, Jesus will come and raise us to eternal life in heaven. Jesus is risen, and we too will rise. That's what Easter's about, life. So I have a basket full of stuff that you might just recognize, and I thought what I'd do is let you take some things out of here, and then you can tell the congregation what you got there that is a symbol. Oh, I wanted to put these on. So I would have your full attention, but you were good listeners anyway. Yeah, here we go. Grab something. Charlotte, Teddy, grab something, and you're going to... Still got more things in there. Come on, take something. Okay. Here you go. All right, I'll just point to you, and you shout out to the congregation all these signs of new life. Here we go. What's that? It's a mother hen with baby chicks, isn't it? What you got? Yeah. Monarch butterfly on the flowers. Charlotte?
I have
a baby lamb. Teddy? Baby duck. What do you got here?
A bunny!
A bunny!
I have two eggs.
Two eggs. What's that?
A bird.
So Easter means new life. Jesus, say it with me, Jesus is risen. And we have all these signs to remind us, right? Jesus is risen and he gives us life now and eternal life. Will you repeat after me as we pray? Let's fold our hands. Dear God, thank you that Jesus is risen. Thank you for all these beautiful signs. Thank you for our new life now. Following Jesus. And our life to come. When we will live with him forever. Amen. All right, happy Easter. Thanks for coming up. Jesus Christ, our Savior. We come this Easter Sunday weary of breaking news. Really, the term breaking news has been rendered meaningless by the media. I mean, everything can't be breaking news. Every breaking news seems bad anyway. I learned that we can thank the Associated Press for this concept of tagging news as something special to listen up to. In 1906, the Associated Press wanted a way to call attention to news of transcendental importance. And so they use terms like breaking news, news alert, or news flash. This reminded Jim of days when he worked at his college radio station, where they had an AP teleprinter that chugged away day and night, printing out paragraph summaries of the day's headlines. Now, to call special attention, bells would ring out to alert the newsroom. Jim remembers three bells meant, come over and read this. Five bells meant, this is big. And 11 bells meant, history was coming over the wires. So when you look at my husband, you are looking at history. Oh, Jimmy. I, for one, would appreciate if the media would clarify by adding the prefix so we hearers would know if what's coming is good breaking news or bad breaking news, and then we can decide to listen or mute. But don't mute today's news. Mark brings us Easter's good breaking news. And even though it's just eight verses, there's more headlines here that can even fit in today's edition. The top headline, Jesus is risen. The message of Easter, first and foremost, is God raised Jesus, and in the power of the resurrection, he opens us and our world to new and everlasting life. Inside the tomb, the women discovered a young man dressed in white who utters three of the most powerful words ever spoken. He is risen. And everything that follows after this proclamation, the church in Acts, the growth of Christianity through the centuries, and even all of you gathered here this morning bear witness to the power of those words. The second headline, God turns our sorrow into joy. We sing on Easter, thine is the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is your victory, thou o'er death has won. Jesus even descended to the dead. He harrowed hell, I love that, on Holy Saturday to release the captives and free all God's children. And now we have Easter song to sing, even over the grave. Alleluia, that's Easter song. Today let every grieving heart hear it and sing it. Death is not the end. Third good breaking news headline, massive stone is rolled away. On a morning that dawned without hope, three grieving women started out the very moment the Sabbath ended. They were so determined to finish caring for their teacher, healer, and Lord, just as they had done throughout his ministry. But along the way, they worried about that very large stone that sealed the tomb. Who could help them? When they came to the tomb, to their amazement, the stone was already rolled away. A young man dressed in a white robe inside was waiting. Don't be afraid, he greeted them. They had come for one purpose, he gave them another. They wouldn't need their spices. God had a different assignment for them. Go and tell the disciples what you have seen and heard. But they were afraid. The disciples were afraid too. Remember how they had locked themselves up in the upper room out of sight from the Roman authorities? Until the risen Christ came to them, showed them his wounds, shared his peace. From then on, the disciples became fearless witnesses to the resurrection. And no prison, no torture, no threat of death could cause them to deny their faithful confession. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. There are days of great challenge in our lives. Disappointments, illness, relationships broken, and losses that come to each of us. And these are impossibly heavy stones. The women asked each other, "Who will help us roll the stone away?" And the psalmist answered, "Where does my help come from? It comes from the Lord." God will free those who follow him to live in Easter's new life. He is able to remove any obstacle, and we can live fearlessly. But there's still more good breaking news and headlines for us. Even Peter is forgiven. The women were instructed to go and tell the disciples. And Peter. What an inclusion, two words. Jesus knew how much Peter needed to hear that he was forgiven. Peter had denied knowing Christ three times. And that word brings good news to all who need forgiveness. Whatever the sin, regret, or burden you carry, Jesus knows you need to hear that you are forgiven. Sin can wreck hearts and homes and plans and people. But it cannot make God cease loving you. Easter means there's a new beginning for you. At the end of Mark's gospel, there's this good news headline. Jesus goes before us. The women were supposed to go and tell the disciples and Peter that Jesus was going ahead to Galilee, and they would see him there just as he had told them. But Mark tells us the women fled and told no one. Maybe they were afraid they wouldn't be believed. But we know that eventually they did go and tell what they had seen, with fear and with joy. But wait, we've left behind that young man in the tomb who shared Easter's good breaking news. Why doesn't Mark call him an angel? Scholars surmise that Mark wants us to see ourselves in him. And as ones who have been baptized, he's wearing that white robe. See ourselves right there, proclaiming Easter's good news, Christ's death and resurrection, into which we have ourselves now been baptized and joined, and wear Christ's robe of righteousness. His commissioning words are meant for us as much as the women, to send us to our Galilee. Having heard this transforming word, encountered it, the news of crucified and risen Lord, we can ask ourselves, reflect again, now who am I, having heard this word? I am a hearer of the word, a word that seeks a home and finds it in me. What should I do? I am to become good news to the world, a candle lighting up darkness. I can be good news by what I am, by what I say, and by what I do, and this is Jesus' new job for me. As you leave today, why not tune out that endless stream of bad breaking news and give room for Easter's headlines? Jesus deserves more of our listening time. Believing in the risen Jesus won't answer every question or remove all our disappointments. the new life we receive in baptism, joined to Jesus Christ, does not take out the cost of discipleship. And yet we know he goes ahead of us, and that life, not death, has the final word. So do not be afraid. Trust in God. Believe in God's Son. Rejoice in God's love for you. For Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. And we say, Alleluia and Amen.
Please rise. Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. Holy God, we pray for the body of Christ, the church. Guide us all to embody Christ's love in the world. Give us words to boldly proclaim Christ crucified and risen. God of grace, life-giving God, we pray for the renewal of the earth, your good creation. Join our prayers with branches lifted in praise to your Son, that together we may know your abundant life. God of grace, merciful God, we pray for all peoples and nations. Free communities from oppression and war. Teach leaders your way of justice. Empower peacemakers and all who work to end violence and strife. God of grace, liberating God, we pray for people everywhere who long for good news. Roll away the stones that keep people from living with dignity and wholeness. Restore relationships with the forgiveness spoken from the cross. Breathe new life into people struggling to make it through each day. Protect the vulnerable and grant healing to those who are sick. This morning, we pray for Karen Coddington, Chuck Johnson, Janet Brown, Ginny Leahy, Shelley Rainier's stepmother, Marge, Brenda Reich's brother, Tony, Bart Gates' friend, Danny, and those we name you now. God of grace, eternal God, you have swallowed up death forever through the resurrection of your Son. Make us confident that we will feast at your heavenly banquet with those who have died and are now at rest. God of peace, into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love, through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share Christ's peace with one another.
rise now as we continue with the Thanksgiving at the table. Holy God, mighty and merciful, your people praise you, saying, your mercy endures forever. By your promise, you bound yourself to your people of old, blessing them with family outnumbering the stars and calling them to be a blessing to others, showing them steadfast love in every generation and calling them to be a light to the nations. Your mercy endures forever. By your promise, you joined us to Jesus, your beloved, grafting us into your living vine and calling us to bear the fruit of your self-giving love. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me. With this bread and cup, we remember his life laid down and lifted up as we proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and these gifts of bread and wine. Make us a sign of your faithfulness. Send us to tend and cherish the earth and to serve the world with mercy and love. With all the saints and light, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God, through Jesus Christ, in your Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You may be seated. Today we'll be serving communion at two stations in the front of the sanctuary. We invite you to just follow the directions of the ushers. They will invite you forward beginning in the back rows. We have wheat and gluten-free wafers, wine and grape juice, and so you can just indicate to the server which one of those you need. Children who have not yet received First Communion orientation are invited forward for a blessing. And anyone who wishes to come forward is invited for a blessing. We want all to join in this Easter celebration where the Lord is the host and all are welcome. Here the risen Christ is made known to us in the breaking of the bread. Come and eat at God's table. This is the body of Christ given for you and his blood shed for you.
Mountains grand. Today that Jesus Christ has won, so I can face tomorrow, for tomorrow's in your hands. All I need you will provide, just like you always have. I'm fighting a battle you already. My eyes on Jesus Christ, I'll say that it is well. Oh, I know that it is well. We will be with you.
See the morning the joy on the horizon. Here my faith is found. I stand on solid ground. When I feel my hope about to break, I will cling to your unchanging grace. Let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain. Solid rock, I stand all over the ground and singing sins. So stomp your knee and clap your hands, my feet are on. When I feel my hope about to break, hey, I will catch in your unchanging grace. Hey, let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain. When I feel my hope about to break, hey, I will catch changing race, hey, let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain.